was diagnosed with autism at 13 years old, I wasn't even sure what the word meant. My parents told me, in the most basic way, that it meant my brain worked differently than others. That it wasn't good or bad, it was just different. They explained that there may be certain things that would be harder for me to understand. But I already knew that. I always knew I was different. I guess I just thought I was weird, since that's what people had been telling me my whole life. If I'm being honest, it took me a while to really be able to accept my diagnosis. I mean, I was a teenager, it was COVID, and I was struggling with Zoom calls and isolation. I barely knew who I was. Now I had to figure out who I was as a teenager with autism. I had so many questions, yet I just wasn't ready for the answers. I mean, imagine finding out there's an actual reason why you act the way you do, like a medical reason. What would you do with that information? It also took me a while to be able to talk about my diagnosis. 3 years ago, I never could have imagined I would be standing here, in front of all of you, loving and owning my weirdness. But it wasn't easy. I was bullied all throughout elementary school, to the point where I even had to change schools. But it seemed like no matter where I went, there was this invisible barrier between me and everyone else. I thought that if I could just figure out what I was doing wrong and fix it, I would be accepted. So finally, after 7 years of torment, I asked those who bullied me, why? What was so awful about the way I acted that made you need to make my life miserable? Their answer? I was weird. I just seemed a little off compared to everyone else. I had been searching my whole childhood for an answer, and that's what I got. Though I'm happy to say that I'm now able to look back on my childhood and laugh. Because how is it that nobody noticed? How did I go through all of elementary school, even an evaluation with a neuropsychologist for ADHD, without anyone ever realizing that there was more to it? My parents were as baffled as I was. They didn't realize that my quirks were actual symptoms of something. You see, I could focus, even hyper-focus at times, like when I read the entire Harry Potter series in 1 week. My older sister was the opposite. She had what you call all the classic symptoms of ADHD. She was hyperactive, would always get distracted, and had a harder time in school. My parents were only able to understand what they saw, and they could see that I was the polar opposite of my sister, hence believing that I did not have ADHD, or anything else for that matter. They admit now that they simply didn't know much about autism, having never met anyone on the spectrum before. This made me realize that their understanding of autism came from how it was depicted in the media. I wonder if this is why cases like mine are not recognized as often. So let's make sure we're all on the same page. Autism is a neurological developmental condition characterized by repetitive patterns of behavior and difficulties with social communication. Many of us struggle to deal with change, mandatory actions, and other points of view. Now, that explanation is a lot of words because it really is a complicated condition. And no two people are alike. A saying I like is, if you've met one person with autism, then you've met one person with autism. But being autistic means that I am also neurodiverse. The word neurodivergent is an umbrella term that covers anyone whose brain works differently than most. For example, people with ADHD, autism, dyspraxia, and dyslexia. Today, I'm going to focus on autism to draw from my personal experiences. Did you know that 15 to 20% of the entire world population is neurodiverse? That may not seem like a lot, but it's actually around 400 million people. So let's look at McGill. There are over 35,000 students at this school. So statistically speaking, more than 5,000 of them have some variation of neurodivergence. Which makes me wonder, if so many people in the world are neurodiverse, why don't we talk about it more? Let me let you in on a little secret. Our world is designed for neurotypical people, from 9-to-5 workdays to our education system, even all forms of entertainment like concerts, sporting events, and movies. If you ask me, these were all fashioned for the average neurotypical brain. So let's take an example we can all relate to, high school. You've probably seen movies like Mean Girls, or if you're from my parents' generation, Breakfast Club, that are based on a social hierarchy. There are jocks, nerds, popular kids, and many more. Though maybe less exaggerated in the real world, it is still very much there. Our lives are built off a social hierarchy where everyone automatically knows where they stand and where they want to be. But because I'm autistic, I don't see this hierarchy. I just see a bunch of human beings. I believe this is why neurodiverse kids are often left out, ignored, or seen as weird. For me, life can often feel like everyone around me is playing some elaborate game, and I just wasn't given the rules. You see, we have difficulty understanding social cues, which means we generally don't get metaphors, we tend to be overshares, or we might not realize that most people don't want to hear everything we know about every single one of our interests. Basically, we can't read between the lines. Since we don't intuitively know what things are appropriate to say or what facial expressions go with certain situations, we take examples from the people around us. This is called masking, and it helps us to fit in. But it's important to know that masking does not fix everything. It is something we have learned over time to help us appear normal, but it does nothing to help us feel normal. One of the most annoying things about being autistic is how my senses always feel like they're in overdrive. For example, going downtown is unusually difficult for me. There are just too many things going on. While you might be able to subconsciously tune these things out, I am experiencing it at 1,000%. I could be just walking down the street and suddenly be hit with the smell of smoke. 10 feet later, it's pretzels, and then bam, urine. All the while, the sounds of car horns and construction are blaring in my ears, not to mention all the people knocking me around as they go about their business. Suddenly, my mind shuts down. It feels like my brain is being filled with endless information, but I can't process any of it. Now I'm hyperventilating because I can't even remember where I was going. This is something that me and countless other people deal with every single day. It's unbelievable to think that so many neurodiverse people go through their lives struggling because they aren't diagnosed and are therefore not able to get the resources they need. It's only thanks to the help I get from school, my loving family, and the acceptance of my friends that I'm able to thrive in a world that wasn't made for me. But these are just my experiences, and I'm just one person. It's important to remember that there isn't just one form of autism. It's a spectrum. Just like how no two people are the same, no two brains are the same either. Nick Walker, an autistic author and educator, says, "The idea that there is one normal or healthy type of brain or one right style of neurocognitive functioning is no more valid than the idea that there is one normal or right gender, race, or culture." Think about that for a second. Who decided what the definition of normal was, and why haven't we challenged it? I am tired of forcing myself into a neat little box just to conform to society's expectations. For anyone struggling, I need you to hear this. It is hard to be different, and even harder to be accepted for those differences. There may be times where you feel completely alone, like no one could possibly understand what you're going through. But you're not. Because there will always be people in this world who will love and accept you for who you are. And even though there are certain aspects of autism that do make my life difficult, I would never trade it for a normal brain. Because I love the way my brain works. It allows me to see and experience the world from a completely different perspective. This is why I'm asking you to start celebrating each other's differences. Be curious. Don't be afraid to ask questions, because that's how it starts, with the people. the people like you and me who are not afraid of what they don't understand.